itself. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it from us with His blessing and mercy, inshallah. Today is my first time of Tezkirah. And the topic given to me is our heroes, works and life. So what mostly comes to our minds when we are talking about the heroes of Islam? So there is no one other than the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to start with. That's our best option. And if we start with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we are actually not we are not wrong, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also called us and asked us to follow the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So starting from the Tezkirah, I deliver on Saturday morning after Salat al-Fajr about al-Iqtida al-Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to follow the footsteps and the lifestyle of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Inshallah, we understand what is Sunnah. This is well known, inshallah. May Allah make it easy for us to follow the Sunnah of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But today, I just want us to see Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as an institution. If we see Rasul as al-jama', as a university, or something beyond that, where every part of life, everyone goes to get their hajj, what they need, their needs on daily basis. If you need something in terms of engineering, so you go to the Department of Engineering in the university. If you're talking about to how to economize your wealth, your lifestyle, you will find a department. This is exactly how Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam is. I just want us to talk about the social aspect of his life. I'm not going to be telling you stories. We know stories of Rasul, we know how Rasul life was. But what I just want us to pick is a lesson on something very light and simple that we might be neglecting it and see it as something that is not really important. And neglecting this kind of things is actually going out on the footsteps of Rasul. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked us to follow Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said that whatever Rasul bring to us, we have to put on it very strongly. And whatever man haakum anhu fantahu, whatever Rasul said, don't do this, we should just do this. Allah said this in the Holy Quran. So we have an option rather to follow him and just leave whatever he said, we should go near him. What I just want to talk about is ifshaa salam. It's very simple as that. Ifshaa salam, saying assalamu alaykum, assalamu alaykum. Is this very important? It's actually very important. According to the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say salam, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, or assalamu alaykum. This is there before Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How? According to al-Sheikh al-Imam Abu Zakariya Yahya al-Nawawi, the writer of Riyadh al-Salihin, every Muslim knows Riyadh al-Salihin, is very famous book. This great Sheikh, he said, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam alayhi salam, Allah asked him, who are great Muslim people? They were sitting now, just group of malaika. Allah asked him to go and pray. Then he went. He said, assalamu alaykum. Just like that. Then the malaika replied him and saying that, wa alaykum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This hadith is sahih, muttafaqun alayhi. Muttafaqun alayhi means the hadith that narrated by both Imam al-Bukhari or Muslim, first category of hadith. وَعَلَيْكُمُ السَّلَامُ وَرَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ وَبَرَكَاتُهُ. Then in another riwayah of Muslim, he said, وَزَادُوا وَبَرَكَاتُهُ. And they increased. They said more than what he said to me. wa barakatuh. Why this is so important? It's very important if we look to the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us to follow Rasul, right? And that means Rasul will never say something except from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's either revealed to him direct by Angel Jibreel, or Allah puts it in his mind. And he will find it in his actions, or in his words, we call it hadith. Or something said in his presence, and he didn't say it's wrong. That is hadith. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the book of Quran that whenever we want to go to someone's house, that we shouldn't enter any house. لا تدخلوا بيوتا غير بيوتكم حتى تستأنسوا وتسلموا على أهلها. We shouldn't enter a house that is not belong to us, except we stay here. We ask them, can we enter? وتسلموا على أهلها. The word of salam alayhi wa sallam. وتسلموا على السلام. May peace be upon you. This is the first. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran as well, in another verse, that whenever they offer you salam, they greet us. فَحِلُّوا بِأَحْسَنَ مِنْهَا. Greet them with the better than the one they gave you. Like they say, assalamu alaikum. If you go to return, it is better for you to say, wa alaykum salamu wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. The better one, or if you cannot increase it, you cannot make it more than, if my brother says salam to me now, it's better for me to say wa alaykum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. If I cannot do more than what he said, it's better I just remind him in the same form. If we look to the Quran, we find the law. Okay, another one, when Ibrahim alayhi salam, Allah sent an angel to him after they went to home, or before they went to home. They got to Ibrahim alayhi salam, what happened? Salamu alaykum kawmun kawmun. When they got to Ibrahim alayhi salam, the word that he offered him was salam. فَقَالَ سَلَامًا قَالَ سَلَامًا فَقَالُوا سَلَامًا. They said salam to him, and he replied with salam. But the full word of assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh is from Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his son. How it become his son? According to Amr ibn al-As radiallahu anhu, in this hadith also, you can find it in Riyadh Sahih Bukhari, Sahih Muslim. What did he say? He said a man came to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he asked Rasul, "Hal min Islam al-Khayr?" Which better form I can say salam? Spreading peace. How? Which one is the better form to say it? The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, تُطْعِمُ الطَّعَامَ, share food for people, for needs, as we are doing during Ramadan. We can do beyond Ramadan. It's very, very wicked. Watch salam, and spread salam to people. This is very important. The last part of hadith, Rasul said, عَلَى مَنْ تَعْرَفْ وَمَنْ لَمْ تَعْرَفْ. Say it to those you know and the people that you need. If you meet a Muslim on the road, the best thing for you is to say assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. You see that this is very important in our daily life. Nowadays, if you enter some office, and it's very surprising that we are all Muslims. Some people just enter office, then they go directly to your seat. Without saying salam, I was in an office, the office of the professor. Then the professor came in with the bags and everything. All the staff were just like looking at him. Then he went to his seat. Every morning, they haven't seen themselves before. So this is something that is out of the sunnah of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You might be looking at it as something very easy. This is nothing. If I meet someone on the road, I look at this. It's okay, that's a salam. You greet that person, but it's better to say salam. Why we need to say salam? Or salam is better than to just push ourselves, to just any form of greeting, because of two things. Two middle things. Number one, you pray for your brother or Assalamu alaikum, may peace of Allah be upon you. Assalamu alaikum, may Allah peace be and blessed be on you. And he will pray for you, but even to the extent that you see some people, because they understand Arabic, they will say that, okay, I meet only Dr. Omar, I meet only Brother Siddiq. Then I want to show that I know Arabic. So I will not say Assalamu alaikum in Arabic, is for many people. So I would like to say Ka, for him to know I know what I'm saying. I meet Sister Fatima, I will say Salamu alaikum. This is wrong. According to Imam Nawawi, the best thing for even for one person is for you to say Assalamu alaikum. This is Sunnah of Rasulullah. That's number one thing. Number two, Adam al-Isti'ilah. Islam doesn't want us to do like this for other people. This is the major one, even it's bigger than the first one. Adam al-Isti'ilah ala al-Akhareen. For you to see yourself, because I have makana, I'm prominent, I have a post, I have a great position, or I see myself like I'm imam, I'm a sheikh, I think I'm better than him now because he's going to drink alcohol, he's playing games. You won't even go today, no one go tomorrow. I will end up this short that we are with a very interesting story I have today. On the group of Adam al-Islam, Rabbi al-Adam al-Islam in the world, Islamic literature group, but what's that? Someone, one of the professors, drew one video and with caption of, this is the best ever khutbah I had in my life, a professor of Islamic studies. Then people were commenting, they liked the video, but someone said, I didn't even pray to see the face of the khatib. Why couldn't you just make it as audio? Because the khatib, they don't want to listen to him. I don't, what I want to use from this khutbah, the khatib was crying. He said, you know, he's a sheikh, and he's moved him to one of the leader of Muslim country. Very popular man, sheikh. Then he met one man around 12 o'clock in the night, when he was in 1968. The man was coming from, I think, beer place, like a bar, when he went to drink alcohol. Then the man went closer to him and called him his name. Then he said, I know this man, know me. Very arduous. The man was an old man. Then the man told him, Ya Habibi, Ya Walad, I want you to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive me. Because I am ashamed of myself to ask Allah forgiveness. I know He will never forgive me. The sheikh said, why you say this? This is too big. Allah yakfiru dhunuba jami'a. I didn't know your sin, but Allah will forgive you. Then he said, I'm ashamed to look at Sama and say Allah forgive me. Can you say it for me? Then he said, Ya Abi, my father, and I will forgive you. The following day, they met his father, so they keep him in their company, like youth. They were going together from that Monday until Thursday of that week. For 4 days, he did not go to drink. Then they dropped him in his house. At late night of that Thursday, they left. Went back to their madrasa, to their school. Then that man went to his wife. The next day, they were expecting him to come for Friday prayer. They discovered that he's dead. He's dead. Then he sent someone to his house. Go and check. Check. What happened to him? We didn't see him in Juma. Maybe he went back to pray. Then his wife said, he passed away. But he sent me a message to Sheikh that dropped him yesterday. Then Sheikh ran to his house. He said, he told me to tell you what happened yesterday. What happened to him? He said, after praying Salat al-Isha, he dropped him, then he made a wudu and called his wife. He said, my dear wife, I know with these 4 days, I am very sincere with Allah. Inshallah, now I've already made my wudu. I'm afraid to wake up tomorrow. Maybe I'll go back to my sleep. I will pray 2 rak'ah and I will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to take my role. He said this, late night on Thursday, and during Jumu'ah, they pray over you as a dead body. Simply end. You don't need to do istilah on anyone. Being blind, being from poor countries, being from any nationality, as far as we all Muslims, saying salam to everyone we meet. Even Rasul used to say salam to sisters when he see them, they would be salamu alaykum. Not looking at them. Rasul used to say salam to young boys. They are playing, they would say salamu alaykum to you. So this is a great sunnah. It's a very, very great sunnah. You can look at it as something small, but it's great. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our Islam easy for us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala count us among those who be faithful in the day of judgment and make our peace their way to the temple. Subhanahu wa ta'ala wa bihamdihi. Inshallah, la ilaha illa anta.